here's a restorative practice that you can do to provide the body with more energy and balance. You'll need a bolster or pillows, something to put under the bolster. I have a block, blanket or a pillow for the head, and pillows for the knees. And that will probably do it. So let's begin. Sitting up against the bolster, bring the soles of the feet together and allow the knees to open out. Gently coming back over the bolster. If the forehead is slightly higher than the chin, that would be great. Maybe blankets over the body would also feel good. If the back bend feels too intense, raise the height behind you. So put more pillows under your bolster. Arms can be out wide if that's comfortable, or in. You want to make sure that this is a pose that you can really relax into and let go. Find your breath. Just watching the body breathing. Allow the body to melt over the bolster, releasing tension from the top of the head down to the toes. bringing the arms in, helping the knees come up. It might feel better to roll to one side rather than come straight up. Taking a few moments here. Before pushing the body up. So the next pose is child's pose. Taking the knees wide and the big toes touching, you can use the same bolster and take the body over the bolster, turning the head to one side. You want your back flat. If it's not, you can raise the bolster up and go higher, or you can also do a child's pose on your back and just hug the knees in, or a passive rest pose would be an appropriate replacement if child's pose just isn't relaxing for you. A blanket over the back can feel lovely here. Find your breath again. Check that there isn't weight in your arms and that you can really let go. Feeling the body melting. And on the next inhale, lifting up the head and gently turning your head the other direction. slowly come up, placing the bolster to the side. And then coming onto the back for supported bridge. Pressing into the feet, lifting up the hips, and placing a cushion or a block under the hips. The arms can be long alongside the body, or maybe bend the elbows like cactus arms. Just check that the neck is long and comfortable. Everything in this pose is relaxing and letting go. Maybe the inner thighs stay engaged, but if you can, everything. Check that belly, let it soften. Check the face and the shoulders. And just watching the breath, feel and encourage the letting go as the body releases into this pose. For the last minute or so, see how much more you can let go. How much more can the body soften and melt? The space between the eyebrows, the jaw, the hips, everything lets go. Deepening the breath, slowly taking the arms down. And then drawing the knees, taking the arms down, and then drawing the knees into the chest, maybe one at a time. Inhaling to take the legs up. If it feels good to point the toes and draw them back, go for it. Maybe circle the ankles a few times. And then float the legs there, relaxed, effortless. Connecting to the breath. Up the backs of the legs and gently stretching the hamstrings before drawing the knees in, taking the feet down to the mat, pressing into the feet as you inhale, lift up the hips and remove the cushion. Roll to the side. And then coming up to set up for our final pose, Mountain Brook. For Mountain Brook, you'll need a pillow for the head, a blanket, a couple inches high, maybe 3 inches at the most. For the base of the shoulder blades. And then a bolster to go under the thighs and knees. Blankets, eye pillows, all of those can be used in any of these poses. So once you've got your bolster set up under the legs, use your hands on your blanket to slowly lower the body down. And that way you can feel if it's in the right position. You want to feel a gentle lift in the upper chest, and the arms should be able to open out wide like airplane wings without hitting the blanket. Check that your breathing is easy, that there's nothing that feels constricted here. This is a great pose for helping with postural imbalances like kyphosis, the rounding of the upper back. It's also great for improving breathing in the upper chest. So just as in all the other restorative poses, check that you're as comfortable as possible and then find your breath. Watching the body breathing. Encourage the letting go, feeling as if every part of the body is melting over the props. arms in, bending the knees, rolling onto one side, removing the blanket, and lying on the side for a few moments. When you feel ready, pushing up to a comfortable seated posture, coming back to that breath, leaving hands on the lap or drawing them to heart center, coming into the vibration of Om three times, feeling that vibration in the body and space around you, that uplifting, healing vibration. Three Oms, exhaling, inhaling.